Weatherscope.
Well, there's a major rain event for the Northeast, and it's going to make for a wet commute this morning from Maine to New York City. Good morning. Welcome to Weatherscope. I'm Rick Griffin.
And I'm Cheryl Lemke. Now, the storm system is followed by a cold front that's going to be lowering temperatures across the Deep South. But of immediate concern this morning is Atlantic City, New Jersey, where record rainfall overnight has caused flooding around the gaming capital. And as we check out some rainfall amounts, boy, heavy rain has been inundating the Northeast. And again, for Atlantic City, a record rainfall. Not only the heaviest rain ever for that day, but the heaviest rain ever in a 24-hour period. Well over 13 inches of rain. Serious flooding continues for Atlantic City and likewise all across Atlantic County in New Jersey. So traveling is not being recommended this morning. There's also been some significant rain, too, for Dover, Delaware, and even around New York City, over 3 inches of rain. So for coming into work this morning, coming in from Long Island on the LIE, be really careful because, again, the roadway is very wet and very slippery this morning. Now, there will be somewhat drier air, we think, punching in around around Washington, D.C. and up towards Philadelphia today. But the vast majority of the Northeast still has a chance to see more showers and more thunderstorms. And unfortunately, more waterlogged rainy conditions, too, for the waterlogged areas in New Jersey. So again, that could only exacerbate existing flooding problems. It's a pretty complex low-pressure system that's bearing down on the Northeast. We have a surface low coming in through the eastern lakes, our main surface low right over New Jersey. And that low continues to pull in the moisture from off the Atlantic, and that is causing some very heavy rainfall. A thick canopy of clouds, too, shrouds most of the Northeast and the New England states this morning. And again, the rain continues to come down. Luckily, though, the heaviest rain, though, has been occurring just off the coast, but we're still seeing some moderate to occasionally heavy rain, too, coming down over portions of New Jersey, the rain surging northward over towards Connecticut. Widespread rains right now for Bridgeport and Hartford, Connecticut, back over towards Block Island and Providence, Rhode Island, up towards Boston. So, again, a very slow morning commute. Give yourself some extra driving time to get to your destination. And besides seeing the heavy rain, that low also causing some stiff winds throughout the area. Gale warnings have been posted throughout the Northeast, and with that stiff easterly flow, we'll have to watch out for the possibility of beach erosion and coastal flooding. To the Southeast, though, much calmer. Few stray showers have been flaring up across the northern Gulf, but besides that, here comes our cold front, and that cold front will be driving in some cooler and drier air, so a beautiful weekend should be gearing up for the Southeast. Rick?
Cheryl, as we look at the West, the remnants of a tropical storm are moving away from the Pacific Northwest. But the outlook could be one of severe storms today as we check on the northern plains, much like yesterday when powerful thunderstorms ripped through parts of Oklahoma, and again, could do so again today. This is Owosso, a town just northeast of Tulsa, which saw not only a heavy rain, but wind gusts of 60 miles an hour. The high winds took out trees and power lines in the area, not to mention kind of a wet commute for some of you. Portland, Oregon, you got a pretty good shot of rain today, but you'll get a break now that the remnants of the tropical storm Ignacio have moved on into western Canada. Portland's rain was a day-long event on Wednesday, but those of you in western Oregon will be trading in the raindrops for partly sunny skies and a high near 80 degrees. The official total, Portland International Airport, 0.76. That's the first rain since